Last May, the NFL owners announced a policy requiring their players to either stand for the national anthem or remain in the locker room during the anthem. Anyone kneeling or protesting would be fined. But what a difference a few months make, as the NFL has now announced that it won't implement its own new policy. So this weekend, Kenny Stills and Albert Wilson of the Miami Dolphins took a knee during the anthem of their season opener. Their teammate, Robert Quinn, stood, but he did so with his fist in the air. So what penalties will they face? None. An NFL spokesman tells Sports Illustrated, the status quo continues as productive discussions are ongoing on the important work of social justice. Now, you might have forgotten that this all started back during the Obama era in about August 2016. That was when Colin Kaepernick refused to stand in a preseason game for the 49ers. After that game, he defended his gesture, saying, I'm not going to stand up to show pride in a flag for a country that oppresses black people and people of color. To me, this is bigger than football. There are bodies in the street and people getting paid leave and getting away with murder. Well, remember, Kaepernick basically started on police brutality, but now this has morphed into a much broader movement that the NFL felt that it had to support. So in an attempt to appease the protesting players and put the kibosh on the protests, the league committed nearly $100 million earlier this year to what they call social justice initiatives. But just where does that money go? Well, $73 million of it will be divided into three organizations. 25% to the United Negro College Fund, 25% to Dream Corps, which is kind of a left-wing social justice group founded and led by Van Jones. Their goal is to lower the prison population by half and provide sanctuary to all. Not sure what that means. And then half of the $73 million will go to something called the Players Coalition. Now, the Players Coalition was a nonprofit quickly formed by a group of NFL players to guide the social justice conversation and receive any money that the NFL might be willing to donate. And get this, they've consulted with George Soros-backed criminal justice groups and the Liberal Center for American Progress, this according to ESPN. The coalition is led by 12 players, but it was founded by Malcolm Jenkins of the Eagles and retired player Anquan Boldin. The group advocates for everything from criminal justice reform to racial equality to voting rights. But some players have withdrawn from the group, including Michael Thomas and Eric Reed, who was one of the first players to protest right along with Kaepernick. In an interview with Slate, Reed trashed the NFL's attempt at hush money, that's what he called it, basically called it, and resigned from the Players Coalition altogether, claiming that Malcolm Jenkins told him the money would come from funds that are already allocated to breast cancer awareness and Salute to Service. So it would really be no skin off the owners' backs. They would just move the money from those programs to this one. We didn't agree with that because we weren't trying to cut other worthy programs. Well, whatever the case, the NFL thought it could buy its way out of any further controversy surrounding the anthem by basically paying off a patchwork of left-leaning groups. But it didn't completely work. On the broadcast side of this issue, the increasingly liberal ESPN has decided it will simply no longer air the playing of the Star-Spangled Banner at all before Monday Night Football. Well, I hope Colin and company are happy with that. The fans aren't. Viewership of the NFL season opener, at least, was down 13% from last year and reached the lowest rating for an opening game since 2009. They did better yesterday, though. Well, I have a better idea of all this. If these players or the NFL were truly concerned about making life better for minorities in the United States, why not consider dropping the political chip on your shoulder and consider working with the Trump administration? I know you might not like his tweets. I get that. But I have a question. Are you aware of President Trump's openness to criminal justice reform?
Working together, we can restore the rule of law, keep dangerous criminals off our streets,
and help former inmates get a second chance at life, and a second chance that many of them will really succeed at, if only given the chance. America is a nation that believes in the power of redemption.
Or his willingness to commute the sentences of those with exemplary records and unusual circumstances, like Alice Marie Johnson.
My message to President Trump is, thank you so much, President Trump, for taking the time to really look at my case and to really look at me. And as I've said before, I promise you, President Trump, I will make you proud.
I love that moment. And of course, President Trump's policies have made this the best time ever for Black Americans to find jobs. Black unemployment is at a stunning and record low, currently at 6.3 or 6.5%. Although the president disagrees with the anthem kneelers, and we all know that, he also offered them an olive branch back in June.
You should stand for our national anthem. You shouldn't go in a locker room when our national anthem is played. I am going to ask all of those people to recommend to me, because that's what they're protesting, people that they think were unfairly treated by the justice system. And I understand that. And I'm going to ask them to recommend to me people that were unfairly treated, friends of theirs or people that they know about. And I'm going to take a look at those applications. And if I find, and my committee finds, that they're unfairly treated, then we will pardon them or at least let them out.
So my question is, how many of the NFL players have taken him up on that offer, reached out to the president? Well, maybe some have used back channels, I don't know. But to not do so confirms the suspicion that the anthem protests are more about ideology than equality. And that would be a real shame. And that's The Angle.